Now she enters puberty. When she enters puberty, suddenly changes will start coming in the primary follicle, and primary follicle start developing more layers of cells around it and change into secondary follicle. Then the secondary follicle changes into the tertiary follicle. How is it possible? If you go through NCRT, NCRT says primary follicle develops more layer of the cells around it, so granulosa layers, and develop a theca. Theca is again a word which is for the cavity or a wall of a cavity. So this wall comes, is developed with the help of cortex. Cortex is the portion of the stroma of the ovary in the last class I told you. So the cortex synthesizes theca around the primary follicle, and now the primary follicle has changed into secondary follicle. Please remember, this cell inside remains as such. That cell inside is still at primary oocyte stage, and it is arrested at prophase first, or you can say it is arrested at the diagenesis. Now the secondary follicle further undergoes development. The cortex has developed a theca. This theca differentiates now into two layers. The outer layer is called theca externa. The inner layer is called theca interna. The theca interna is cellular in nature, and theca externa is fibrous in nature. So as these development take place, there is a cavity which develops inside the follicle, which is called as antrum. Now the role of antrum, antrum carries nutritive fluid, which is called here as liquor folliculi. Liquor means alcohol, or liquor means the liquid, and folliculi means follicular. So the follicles have synthesized and stored good amount of nutrition in a liquid form inside that cavity, which is called here as antrum. So let me repeat once again. During the fetal embryonal stage, oogenesis starts. There are a couple of million oogonia in each ovary, in each fetal ovary, and they start undergoing development. They develop into primary follicles. The primary follicles carry is each primary follicle carries a primary oocyte inside. Oocyte is diploid in structure. Now please remember, there are many primary follicles in the fetal ovary, but as she is born and as she grows and enters into puberty, many of these follicles undergo degeneration, and when she enters puberty, each ovary just carries 60,000 to 80,000 follicles. So rest of the follicles have undergone degeneration, which is also called as follicular atresia, or these follicles are called as atresic folliculi. Now what happened next is, these primary follicles start changing into secondary follicle when she enters puberty. So a theca starts developing around, more layer of granulosa cells will come, and then the secondary follicle still carries primary oocyte inside. Secondary follicle now start changing into tertiary follicle because theca starts undergoing changes. Outer layer will become fibrous and is called externa. Inner remains cellular and is called interna. And a cavity develops inside which carries the nutritive liquid called as antrum. So tertiary follicle, this is an important word mentioned in NCRT. So the primary follicle changed into secondary follicle when she enters puberty, and then quickly changed into tertiary follicle. Now at this stage, primary oocyte will become active and come out of the arrest and resume its division and divide into two cells, but unequal cells. Now please pay attention to the topic of the male. In the case of male, what we learned was the primary spermatocyte undergoes meiosis to form two equal cells, and these cells are called as secondary spermatocyte. But what happens in the case of the female is the primary oocyte, which was arrested at prophase first, when enters, when again resume its division, it will not give rise to two equal size cells. It will give rise to two unequal size cells. One cell is called secondary oocyte, haploid. So chromosomes, or you can say nucleus, is equally divided, but cytoplasm is unequally divided. The other cell is called as the first polar body, which will degenerate in the case of the human reproductive system. Now the tertiary follicle carries a secondary oocyte, and outside there is a small polar body. Now why this cell is small and why this cell is big in size, let me give you the reason. We all know that the nutrition is given by the female, and we all know that the sperm contributes. I have told these topics before, if you remember, regarding the heterogametes. Remember I told in the classes that the female contributes good amount of cytoplasm to the zygote, and sperm contributes minimum or otherwise, because sperm contributes no cytoplasm to the next generation. So the same reason is here, because the secondary oocyte will later change into egg. So it should carry a good amount of cytoplasm, full of nutrition, and the polar body is because it is supposed to degenerate. So why should a mother cell divide into two equal half and give less nutrition to the egg and waste the other cell? So because this cell is going to undergo degeneration, so it need not to be given any amount of nutrition. So minimum cytoplasm goes with polar body, and maximum cytoplasm full of nutrition goes with the secondary oocyte. I hope this point is clear to you. So the tertiary follicle is the stage when this arrest is over. Please remember, in spermatogenesis there are no arrests, but in the oogenesis you have learned one arrest here, another one is coming later. So this arrested process gets resumed and then over, and tertiary follicle now carries a secondary oocyte, also a first polar body, which will degenerate. Now what happens next? This tertiary follicle, which carries a secondary oocyte, will quickly mature into Graafian follicle. Now Graafian follicle is the stage of follicle which is supposed to rupture. It will undergo a bursting rupture. It will blast, and finally the egg will come outside, and the rest of this structure will change into corpus luteum. Now let's understand. The tertiary follicle carries a secondary oocyte. The secondary oocyte will quickly undergo meiosis second, but again arrested at metaphase. So now the second arrest is there, and remember that at this arrested stage only ovulation takes place. So during ovulation, please be careful and listen. During